Hello everyone, my name is Maple Blossom, your medical trainer here, and we are back for maybe the second to last Alpha Sapphire Delta episode, Nuzlocke. Last time, we fought against Steven, and now we are meeting with Sinead. So, you came for me, thanks for that. That's really good, Nick. I really feel it right here. Since you've been a good boy, I think I'll give you something I've been keeping. Look, the paintings that cover the walls of this tower. CDs are the history of humanity, of Pokemon and nature itself. They are the tales that have been passed down by my ancestor, the Draconids, for thousands of years. And now, I will pass that history and lore on to you.
Okay, right into our story bit.
Thousands of years ago, in the primal age long lost, the world was overflowing with natural energy. Primal Groudon and Primal Kyogre fought over the energy in endless, furious clashes. In the face of Primal Groudon and Kyogre's great power, people could do nothing. The only choice was to watch as disaster upon disaster swept over them. It was in such a time that a great many meteoroids poured from the darkness of space, from a place higher even than the heavens, and the meteoroids fell into multitude upon a waterfall that had long been home to a tribe of dragon-type Pokemon users. Okay, that's it. That's the end of the first chapter of my tale. I'll tell you the next part of the story on the next floor. Look forward to it.
Okay, good story. Though you ruined a possible timeline for Pokemon games with your story, but still. Or rather, how Nintendo controlled it, ruined it. But that's another opinion. Ooh, Ariados! But it's poison. And not that high level though. What does Dazzling Gleam do to you? If you use Sucker Punch, that's no problem. Not that much. What does Round do then? Oh, we are speed type. Or Sucker Punch goes first, right, if I use an attacking move. That's right. Pin missiles doesn't seem to do that much. If you can stop hitting, and thank you. And let's do Round again. Oh, crit, but it's perfect. I will catch a Pokemon, even if I said that I probably won't. Oh. Bag, we will use an healing, because if it for some reason has pursuit, I'm not taking that risk again. Full restore. I don't need that heart attack before going to the emergency part of the hospital where I'll be working today. I will maybe take care of people that have a heart attack, but I don't want to have to go there myself to be taken care of. Yeah, let's just put in train as a defense. And it tried sucker punching, that doesn't work. Pokeballs, Ultra Ball, sure. And two, and a three. And a capture. So we got an Ariados. Ariados. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but you should still understand me, and that's the most important part, not the correct pronunciation, especially when there are few official pronunciations. Ariado's feet are tipped with tiny hooked claws that enable it to scuttle on ceilings and vertical walls. This Pokemon constricts the foe with a thin and strong silk webbing. Give a nickname? Yeah, kinda have to. And we're just gonna go with... we can save Tyrant for something else and just go Tarrant as Tarantula. Ariados is not a tarantula, but yeah. Because no Pokemon is in a real life animal. Something else is hanging from the ceiling or what? Can climb up here for a night. Please! Don't do that. Another Ariados. Blue is at least faster than the last 046. Got away safely. Dragon Scale. That's Kingdra's evolution item, yeah. So don't need it. Why are you so slow? Okay, I'm gonna use the normal steering pad because the DS joystick thing didn't work. There are a lot of Ariados. Get away safely. Nothing. And there's Sinia once again. Oh, here you are. Let me continue. It's finally time for chapter 2. Here we go. At last, right? I know you're thrilled. Well, kinda. The meteors shone with a rainbow brilliance as if some great life was held within. That was when, as if drawn by the brilliance, a Pokemon that shone in a blazing emerald hue descended from the heavens. That Pokemon was none other than Rayquaza! Rayquaza's power overwhelmed of the two primal Pokemon and peace returned to the world. The people of Hoenn revered Rayquaza as a true savior. A thousand years after this time, the meteors once again fell. A huge meteoroid, far greater than any before, struck the planet, boring deep into the ocean and leaving behind a crater larger than any other. The land born of this event later became known as Suitopolis. That was a short chapter too. But we only just left the starting line. There's a long way for that. Don't fall behind. Yeah. Don't be so stingy. Now our tales reach the best part. Suitopolis was born from a great meteoroid strike. The Great Meteoroid was the first of many disasters to befall humanity. When it punched into the planet, the land cracked beneath it and a great revealing of natural energy poured from beneath Hoenn. Thirsting for that energy... Sorry mother, I'm not gonna answer the phone right now. But then Primal Kyogre and Primal Groove once again woke. The people had a wish, a memory from a thousand years before. They wished that the legendary Pokemon clad in emerald light would appear again. The huge meteoroid that lay at the heart of Suitopolis gave off a boundless brilliance. In its brilliance, it resembled a vast and powerful keystone. And once again, Rayquaza descended from whence it was held. The people fell to their knees before Rayquaza and made a wish for salvation. As they did, a great change came over the legendary Pokemon. It was enveloped in blinding light. As the light receded, they beheld a Rayquaza beyond all knowledge, a sublime figure, incandescent with overwhelming life force, and a completely broken and overpowered Pokemon. It was the humanity's wish that broke about Rayquaza's transformation in the face of the Rainbow Stone. Yes, a wish, an intangible thing invisible to the eye. Yet this wish bound people and Pokemon together, enabling the legendary Pokemon to change its appearance. Doesn't it remind you of something? That's right, it sounds like a Mega Evolution, doesn't it? Well, yeah, a Mega Evolution without an item that becomes completely broken because you can still have an item on the Pokemon. is like tied with Mega Mewtwo for the highest stat total of any Pokemon that exists. But it doesn't have Hyper Beam. Ow. Technically this should be fine to try and get away. Because Claydol would have been locked in. Rest. No matter what. And heal blue now. Because that hurt. We'll have Anmark in front because he's so high level, he should be able to outrun pretty much anything that spawns before us. And if we have to fight Zinnia and then probably Rayquaza, I want to leave with a strong Pokemon. And how did the story end? After being transformed by the wish of the people, did Rayquaza save them from disaster? Rayquaza once again confronted Primal Groudon and Primal Kyogre. The golden filaments that sprang from its body covered the sky, an emerald brilliance illuminating the area. A terrible wind rose. The wind and the emerald light visibly shaped the power from sapped the power from Primal Groudon and Primal Kyogre. Drained from their primal powers, the two vanished into the depths of land and sea. Rayquaza watched them go, regaining his usual appearance, then soared back up into the heavens where it dwelt. A witness to these serious events, a tall visitor from a distant land, said, "It is the adult, born of the great disturbance in this world. By the bounds born of mankind's wish and the power of the stones, it will kill the troubles that plague the world." That was when the Draconids constructed their great tower to hold the rainbow stone that had granted Rayquaza its power, and to try to get a little bit closer to Rayquaza in the heavens above. To record the history of their trials and the great feats of mighty Rayquaza, sorry for not pronouncing it correctly, for all to know, they left behind the murals you see here. A giant tower and paintings of the past. You know, I feel like I've seen something like that recently. But now, I suppose it's time for the last chapter in our tale. Come back here! Nowhere to go there, and here we are. At last, we reached the final chapter. Finally. A thousand years of peace followed after that disastrous time, but the Dragony people, learning from their long history of cyclical nature, foretold that the meteoroids would fall on this land again. The meteoroid to come, they prophesied, would be far greater than those that had come before it. This meteoroid would be great enough to break the world forever. In order to prevent this great calamity, those who held the knowledge of the past arrived at the plan. The plan was to invoke Rayquaza, the great savior, and summon it to this land before the meteoroid could strike. And that's it. That's the end of our The Draconid's Tale. I spent a long time thinking about how I could protect the happiness of as many people as possible. What I must do as one who holds both the knowledge and the power, one who bears the heavy wishes of those who could not live up to that fate. Well, I had to be really creative, you know. What have you done, Zinnia? Your adventure counterpart is quite twisted and wicked, so I wanna know. Run. We are high up. We are really high up. And it's nice that it is a night sky despite me recording in the middle of the day.
See that, Aster? You always wanted to watch them, right? The little noids, a million of little glittering stars stars falling from the sky. The show is about to start. Murmur! Aren't we happy now? Yes, what could be better, dear Aster? Welcome to the Dragonhark Altar. Nick, you know what I'm trying to do here by now, don't you? That's right, I will summon Rayquaza to this world to destroy the meteor headed for Hoenn. That is my, it is our duty. Ever since I was a little girl, I have always turned up my eyes to the sky. When I was so full of uncertainty that I thought my heart might be crushed by it. When I was so grief-stricken and alone, I thought my heart might break away. I turned and looked up there, so that my tears would never, ever fall. What about you? Have you ever had to do something like that? I have. Right. I used to watch the stars like this all the time, together with Aster. We were always together, in good times and in bad. I loved her. I loved her with everything I had. But I still lost her. I want to see her. I want to be with her again. My sweet Aster. I will, won't I? With this, just a little longer.
This is turning really sad, because you kind of knew that Aster, she was talking about being together with, was not the Whismur. Murmur!
Yes, I should say good morning. You slept well, didn't you? You looked so adorable when you sleep. Sorry about knocking you out, thing.
She knocked me out? Enough.
I think it's time I gave it a shot. I'm sorry for all the trouble I caused you. If something happens to me, please take this little one.
No, Senia. Be careful.
Okay, here I go. With jeweled bride and borrowed might from the spirits of the departed. For sacred dried in my great sight, my life as well I offer. The keystones that Senia holds are giving off a blind light. A summon thee to aid this fight and save us from disaster. Realize them upon this world. For this do I summon thee.
Rayquaza!
One of the best legendaries out there, in my opinion. Really love it. Both normal color, shiny color, and I said it's the strongest Pokemon to like have ever existed because of its Mega.
Rayquaza. I did it. I did it. Now the world will be saved, Aster. Aster, I did it. Great Rayquaza, hear my wish. Achieve your Mega Evolution. Take hold of your true power. Show me your true face. The Rayquaza that will save this planet.
Nothing.
Senia's keystone doesn't react. Huh? How can this be? I gather all of the keystones that could withstand your great power and summon you here. You came. And yet, why? Come on, do it. Mega Evolve. Why won't you?
Nothing's happening. I don't know.
What? It can't be. The one without enough power is you, Rayquaza? The meteors that should lie within Rayquaza's great body aren't enough? Have these thousands of years drained them of their power?
Wow, that's a nice face on her, but not on me.
This can't be. I can't. Everything I've done till now. Aster, I can't take any more.
Something on me? Ah, I have the meteoroid.
That's...
The glow in Nick's mirror grew even stronger. Don't tell me I have to fight Mega Rayquaza. No, I should be the... That... That meteor is just like a Megastone. Is it attacking? Rayquaza swallowed. Ah, it kinda attacked it like it. If it swallowed the meteoroid, it should have, like, swallowed my entire backpack. Light is spilling forth from within Rayquaza's body. Whoa! Swallowing meteoroids allow it to store as much power as a Megastone? Your meteoroid summoned forth the power needed for Rayquaza to Mega Evolve. Huh, it's amazing. Nick, Rayquaza is trying to build a power. It wants your power for itself to take on. Use everything you got and win over Rayquaza. You have to master it. This is the legendary Pokemon that all Hoenn views as our great protector. And the only one who can direct it now is you. You have to do this.
Do I have ice moves? Because ice is 4 times effective. Ice beam. I don't have ice beam on anything. Use on... it will be not necessary to have it on... Blue. Rock Slide, Earthquake, Hammer Arm. I think I'll remove Earthquake for the time being because I can't teach Earthquake again. And I don't think I can teach Hammer Arm, and Rock Slide is also decently good, I would guess, against Rayquaza because I think Rayquaza has Flying as its second type. Not 100 sure, like just 99. So, Brick Break is also a TM move, so I can remove that. Ice Beam. And in this moment, I would usually save. Okay, everyone, this is technically Nick speaking after I finished the entire game, but that is because there was no breaks. From when you start fighting Rayquaza until you go to the meteoroid, everything like that. So, I will have to end this episode here with this kind of special thing because I think over 50 minutes is a bit long for an episode and I really want to split it into two parts. So, I hope you enjoyed this bit story thing about Rayquaza and you will just have to wait and see what happens in the Rayquaza fight and what's after that in the next one. So have a healthy life, a nice evening, and I will see you in the final episode!